installment one.
Geralt, I shall help you.
Step back.
Stop telling me what to do.
I wonder how long you last.
And above all, beware the witches of Crookback Bog. Try to reach the place where last we were together.
we're together, not much to go on. Damn it.
Perhaps it's best he didn't leave a clearer message. The Wild Hunt broke in here. Surely they saw the projection.
They searched everything. And if they had more time, they'd probably have torn the place to the ground. But that doesn't change the fact that we haven't learned anything. Not about the elf, not about Ciri.
Well, we know they were well acquainted and traveling together.
The witches of Crookback Swamp.
Crookback Bog.
Kira, if you're hiding something...
But... I didn't say...
Why didn't you say anything earlier? I told you Ciri had a run-in with a witch.
Well, I had no idea you meant them. If I'd told you something, you would have rushed off to find them. But we needed first to confirm that Ciri was here, didn't we? I shall tell you everything now, of course.
Now? After I safely led you through the cave?
I can't believe you'd think so poorly of me. Perhaps you do bear a grudge against sorceresses.
Mm-hmm. Can't imagine where that comes from. You know these witches?
I've never met them, but I've read of them. In an old manuscript I found in one of the huts in the village. It mentions the village witches venturing into Crookback Bog at times to liaise between the villagers and the crones, the ladies of the wood. The crones appear to be intolerant of outsiders, but they help the local folk. Apparently, they stop the spread of the plague in Velen.
What's your take on this?
I'd love to shrug it off as the nattering of so many old women, yet... Throughout my first fortnight in Velen, I had horrible nightmares. Something was calling me out into the swamps. One night, I decided to enter the dream consciously. Render it lucid. I confronted the thing directly. It broke contact at once. Peaceful nights ever since.
How do I find them?
The swamps are vast, dangerous, but they say the crones mark the way for peasants who wish to visit them. The manuscript mentions a chapel in Crookback Bog, and from that chapel one must follow a trail of treats.
Treats?
Of course. They didn't read you bedtime stories at Caer Morhen. All normal folk know that witches live in gingerbread houses poised atop chicken legs.
I'll have to see that to believe it.
Take the tome and read it. I truly do believe you'll find your Cirilla. All right then. As a start, let's look for a way out of here.
Good idea. What's this?
The potion I gave him. Why do we even come?
Mysterious mage herbalist. Mysterious mage herbalist. Must have burned these notes himself. The Hunt wouldn't have bothered.
Meaning he knew they were looking for him.
Strange. My medallion's trembling, but there's nothing here. What's with this wall?
It's an illusion. I sensed it as well. I expected we might run into such things, so I brought this.
Meaning what?
The Eye of Nahalani. It dispels illusions. It's easy enough to build, so you're welcome to this one. It's bound to come in handy. And each time it does, you will think of me.
Huh. Thanks. Leads.
Do you feel that? A flow of fresh air from the left. Must be an exit that way.
Good. Let's get out of here.
Wait, there's still the magic lamp.
The magic what now?
Lamp. The elf promised it to me in exchange for my help. And since his return here seems doubtful, I must retrieve it myself. If I can find it, that is. Will you help?
Yeah, I'll help.
Splendid. Come then.
Gvela Glan.
We're certain to find something here. Like another damned riddle to me.
Inscription here.
Show me.
Can you translate the inscription? I can decipher maybe a third, but that third doesn't make much sense.
Give me a minute. I was never any good at the high variant of the Elder Speech. All right. This might seem a bit literal. I'm afraid I can't replicate its sophisticated internal rhymes.
Just translate it to make sense.
Four guardians, four flames, standing proud in a line. The first to light his fire dared not march on the end. The second, by the first, played a woeful lament. The third kept close to his faithful beast. The fourth marched not beside the first, yet, like the second, played a tune. And thus they stood o'er their queen, who slept beneath flickering stars.
Sounds like a riddle, all right. All right, let's see if we can solve this.
Something wrong.